restless, 3 days without sleep, his mind wrapped in a barely perceptible haze, continues east, shaking with the sputtering convulsions and near death throes of his endearing 1962 Chevrolet. The storm follows him closely as it has for 3 days. In the pouring rain on the long dark highways, he sees roadside casualty armadillos on their backs, and owls and bats fly out of the corners of his eyes into the brightening horizon. Despite the solitude in his empty car, he feels he is being watched by more than just the curious deer in West Texas Highway Transit. At dawn, he begins to feel the at first nearly imperceptible signs of the drugs taking effect. As he crosses the border east into New Mexico, there is now no question in his mind about the flavor of the coffee or the sardonic smile of the crusty, overmade waitress. Crossed into more than 2 states at once. His watch stops. He picks up a hitchhiker, some young lady, but unfortunately, as he has been expecting, his car breaks down in some abandoned shantytown known only as Proving Ground. Just remember, she says, I'm holding you responsible for all of this. He cringes at the sound of her voice. A quick glance into the rearview mirror yields to him the vision of the third unattached eyeball. Star of dried cream in the bottom of the styrofoam coffee cup laying on the dashboard smiles at him as somehow, in their loneliness and boredom, her 12-pack dwindling in the midday heat, he forces her into sex. The Chevrolet temporarily fixed, they drift on and come upon a small bar in no place specific. Drunk by evening, she complains of morning sickness, and by morning has noticeably grown in size. 2 days later, still heading east towards the holy angelic temple he has been envisioning in his sleep, she is 9 months pregnant. Later that day, she gives birth to their son. Born with gingham snakeskin cowboy boots and 3 umbilical cords, he is within hours cursing his parents in some otherworldly alien language. And he mutters in perfect English in his sleep, while sucking his mother's breast, of his twisted utopian visions. She looks at him terrified and says, "Remember, I'm holding you responsible for all of this.